The future's unknown for Omaha's Anchor Inn. The owners of the flood-damaged bar battling with the city to reopen the property.
Right now, the city of Omaha is standing its ground, saying the Anchor Inn cannot be rebuilt. But there are signs that the city is willing to work with the owners. In a KETV NewsWatch 7 exclusive, Todd Andrews, live with more on the damage dispute at 6.
Brandy, the Anchor Inn owners say the city is wrong in claiming their building is more than 50% damaged. Now the city wants both sides to sit down and talk. As the Anchor Inn sits damaged and desolate downtown.
Please do not do this to the Anchor Inn.
Crystal Glodin, a former Anchor Inn employee, is in West Omaha reading a letter her granddaughter wrote to the city, begging them to let it be rebuilt. Glodin showed us pictures she took while working at the summertime hotspot, saying the place means so much to so many people.
My daughter's wedding was there. It's not just a bar. That's part of Omaha.
Part of Omaha, the city says, cannot be rebuilt since it's more than 50% damaged by last year's flood. But now the bar's owners are fighting back.
We are very hopeful.
John Portera gave us a tour and showed us documentation he says proves the Anchor Inn was not damaged beyond repair.
And the water inside here is a bright blue. All this is groundwater. No flood water permeated this levee.
The head of Portera's construction team says the water line you see here is from groundwater, not flood water, as the city claims. And what's more,
the level of damage on this building is probably 30%, 35%.
Portera has hired a legal team, too, saying the city's decision to close the building and stop reconstruction are already hurting the bottom line.
Directly affects our corporation from providing a service, from an ability to earn an income.
We do believe that it's more than 50% damaged.
Chief Code Inspector Jay Davis says he understands the owner's claims, and now he says the city wants to meet with them in the next week to 10 days.
We have to sit down as a group and start from ground one to see where this may or may not go. We don't want to keep pointing fingers at each other.
More developments today. The owners also had heavy equipment out at Sandpiper Cove right near the Anchor Inn, clearing off the parking lot there. Now, city inspectors say they did not know about that work, and were they to have known, they would have asked that the work be stopped. Rob?